Julia Marino, ella es una deportista destacada, de hecho fue la primera que nos llevó a los Juegos Olímpicos de Invierno, en Sochi había sido el 2015. Estuvo por Paraguay, bueno, dio sus declaraciones, habló también de su actualidad, qué mejor que escuchar el material.
So before Pyeongchang in January of 2018, I suffered a major accident and I broke my leg here and blew out my knee and tore my ACL. I tore my shoulder and dislocated the top bone here, and it required two surgeries, and I was on crutches for about 10 weeks. And I've been doing rehab, intensive physical therapy, training back in the gym, and I will make my return to snow next week in Bariloche after being off my skis for 17 months. So my recovery has been very long. It has required a lot of patience and resilience to kind of keep going with everything. This was like the first injury that I had that really set me back for a long time. I'm a bit older now, so the recovery process involves a lot more time with physical therapy, in the gym, and before I make my return to snow, I just wanted to make sure that I physically felt very confident, along with mentally being able very confident. So when we go skiing next week, I feel totally in control and an accident like this won't occur again. It's challenging because with a recovery like this, no 2 days are ever the same, and you kind of need to push through those harder moments to be able to get to the next step, and it's been really hard mentally, but I've been so fortunate to work with a great team of doctors, physical therapists, trainers to be able to make next week possible. So I'm not so focused on returning to competitions at this point in the rehabilitation. My bigger focus right now is to just go skiing and to enjoy the sport and see how I feel physically, and then kind of make that decision later down the line. South America is a beautiful country, and the more I see it really inspires me, and I hope one day to live here for a little while and learn how to speak Spanish. Every time that I'm back in Asuncion, it's just this heartwarming feeling. I feel so connected to the people here, and when I first returned right before my first Olympics, I felt like I really felt like a part of me I understood more. The people here are so amazing and generous and nice and welcoming, and it's just a different energy that exists here, and I hope to use my story to inspire others to do whatever they believe they can do, because anything is achievable, and I hope that that message through my story with returning to Paraguay and connecting with where I'm from inspires others to go after their goals and believe in their dreams.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you so much for having me. So good to see you.